It's been a busy month for those working on nuclear issues. Why do you think that world leaders are now so focused on nuclear security, nuclear disarmament?
It's important that delivery is happening after expectations were raised. And expectations were raised by the statement of President Obama in Prague, April last year. Expectations were raised by the two presidents, Obama and Medvedev, in London last year. What is happening now? Delivery. It's important that the revised nuclear posture review is diminishing the role and the number of nuclear weapons foreseen. Number two, the successor summit on nuclear security in Washington is an important contribution to nuclear security and the prevention of terrorism. And number three, the bilateral agreement between the Russian Federation and the US are an embodiment of those promises made.
Let's look more at these specific events. What do you think about the outcomes of this week's nuclear security summit?
It's important that the challenges posed by nuclear terrorism, nuclear security, are addressed heads-on. Heads-on meaning at the highest level, a summit of 47 states. It's not just symbolic, but an expression of the attention devoted to these issues. And number two, of course, nuclear security is part of a wider set of efforts to prevent nuclear proliferation and to prevent the misuse of technologies and assets by terrorists.
What do you think about the new arms reduction treaty between Russia and the United States?
For the CTBT, the Comprehensive Nuclear Test Ban Treaty, the significance is the following. On one hand, the New START Treaty is diminishing quantitatively, number-wise, nuclear weapons. What the Test Ban Treaty is doing to keep a qualitative door closed, and the two are complementary. It's important that the Russian Federation signed and ratified already the Test Ban Treaty. It's important that the US signed the treaty, and there is an expressed intention, not just in presidential statements, but now in the nuclear posture review, that the US administration is intending to move towards the ratification of the Test Ban Treaty.
Tell me what you thought about the US nuclear posture review.
The revised nuclear posture review published recently is an important means of expressing a diminishing belief in nuclear weapons, reducing their numbers, de-emphasizing their role. It's absolutely important that the nuclear posture review is giving a priority to the ratification of the CTBT, the entering into force of the CTBT, as a means of facilitating nuclear non-proliferation.
The NPT review conference is fast approaching. What are you hoping to see coming out of the conference with regards to the CTBTO?
What we will have in May is a gathering of nearly 190 countries. So this is the most representative multilateral gathering. So it's important that the international community is contributing as well to moving forward the process of nuclear non-proliferation and nuclear disarmament. My feeling is that CTBT is an issue around which consensus can be built in the forthcoming review conference, and it's important that this is a uniting issue. We need bridges between the different constituencies in the NPT.